Dawes, Glencross, and Jokinen to shoot for the Flames. No surprise with Jokinen. He's a perfect 2 out of 2. Corey Perry overskates the puck and is stopped.
That was bad right from the start.
I was going to say, had he scored right there, I'm not sure justice would have been served the way that began.
And that takes a little bit of his mind thought off of what he's trying to do. And he's just trying to go straight five hole. But there was no movement at all. It was just a straight come in and try to beat Kiprusoff between the pads.
Dawes is 1 out of 2. Scored in Edmonton. Did not score in Buffalo. Dawes does not score in Anaheim. He went five hole.
Just coming heads up all the way. A little jump start with that back foot. Trying to hold, Jaguar still.
Getzlaf's 0 for 2 on the year. Slowly moving ahead. Now he picks up speed. Great poke check by Kiprusoff on Getzlaf.
Boy, Kiprusoff a couple years ago really sat back in his net and he was getting beat. And now he's a lot more aggressive, especially with that stick. Gets that paddle down very quickly.
Ole Jokinen trying to stay perfect in the shootouts this year. 2 out of 2. Will it be 3 out of 3 to give the Flames a lead? Jokinen, not this time.
Exciting part of the game. Jokinen trying to, deking a lot lately. Making a little bit of move, head down, and tried to fake that he was going to continue on the backhand, and Jaguar just stays there.
Brings up Timo Solani. He has the lone shootout clinching goal for the Ducks this season. With speed, now he stops up and scores. Terrific shot by Solani.
Boy, it comes in so quick, and I'll tell you what, this is just confidence right here. Slows down, he avoids the poke check, and by that time, Kiprusoff had committed to that poke check, then drops his shoulder down and goes right up over the glove.
So Curtis Glencross must score to keep the Flames' hopes of winning alive. And he'll race in. Does he go to that backhand? Shut it wide, and the Ducks win it